Hello, hello, hello from Thailand. I am here to tell you that why Thai people love to ask your age. What is the most important for it? So you're gonna know in this video. Again, I want to describe more that why age is really important for Thai. So when you're gonna call someone in English, you call you. Hey, you, stop, please, something, right? But in Thailand, you're gonna call people mung, the mung in the red one. Is it used among only close friends? Only close friend, normal friend, some normal friend didn't use it. Extremely close because it is impolite and is it ancient, which was used for 100 years and is it not impolite as I said. So when you use mung, impolite, and you're gonna use it with another one, you may face a problem. They may look at you with angry eye, so be careful. Don't use mung with some stranger that you don't know or of Thai government office or anyone. Don't use it because it weird. When you use it, everyone will look at you. So another word that I would recommend you to use is kun, which is the blue one, kun. But kun is good. Is it polite? But sometimes to be polite, too polite can be barrier. You will not get in touch of that people if you use it. Or because kun not only polite but mean respect too. So is it respectful word? Respective something. Then when you use kun, you're gonna use in office, in a movie, in somewhere really official, and mean you don't want to continue know that people anymore. So you don't use it. Exceptional, some couple they use kun because they married and then they want to respect at other, avoid fighting something, so they use kun. It can be, but when I what I share you today is the common word and common use. So if we found kun can keep some barrier of the relationship, and what we gonna do in the middle among mung and kun, I would recommend to use relative identifying word. What is the relative identifying word? Is it something about brother, sister, uncle, auntie, something? Yes, we use it to call stranger, but as that in front of name, because someone we don't know their name, we can use only that. For example, uncle, do you know how to go to the bank? Something like that. But first of all, I would recommend you, we have something different from English. Here is almost relative identifying word that I gonna tell you. First one is brother. Brother we call Pichai. Pichai can be brother. Sister, Pisao. Pisao is older sister, right? Pichai is older brother. But Nong. Nong is younger sister and Nong is Nong Sao is younger sister. Nong Chai is younger brother. So I didn't put Nong in this slide because we are going to use the word to respect people, right? So I share you only Pichai and Pisao, which is older one. and another one is Grandpa and Grandma. For Grandpa, Boo is dad of dad, Boo. Boo. And Ta. Ta is dad of mom. Boo and Ta is male. Grandma, Ya, mom of dad. And Yai, mom of mom. Ya and Yai. Another one, Auntie. Pa. Pa can be used both sister of dad and sister of mom. Na can call both male and female, but from mom side mean younger sister of mom, younger brother of mom, right? Another one, uncle. Uncle in Thai we call lung. Is it used for male? And can be used both older sister of dad. Older brother of dad and older brother of mom. So the last one, R is can be both male or female, and R is used for only that side. Okay, then when we use this, we assume that is it really polite and keep in touch. And as you know that when you go to somewhere, Thai people love to talk with each other even they don't know each other, because we use this word to keep in touch people. But first we have to know their age to identify well. If you call someone P mean they are a little older than you. When you call someone Ta, the male, the old man, older than 60 years old or look very old, Ta. And maybe the old lady, you can call Yai. And another one, Pa, something like older than your mom, little older than your mom. If you can notice from their face, their hair, and Na, something that big older than you, but you don't want to call P, and you think that maybe little younger than your mom, you can call Na. And the last one, Lung, if you found that he look older than your dad, almost similar to Ta, but you want to compliment him that he is not too old to be Ta, you can call Lung instead. And if you really want he feel really happy, you can call P. So it's three level, right? And if you can notice, I will share this. You can see that the yellow one, the relative identifying word that we use is P, Ta, Yai, Pa, Na, and Lung is from mom side. So why we call only from mom side? If you want to call stranger Pu or Ya, or that's it weird. No one use it because we use only word from mom side. For this reason, I will tell you that mom is very important for Thailand. Many years ago, when couple married to each other, they moved to mom side. They will extend the family. They didn't move out. Then the man move to the lady's house and live together, work in agriculture land and help support mom family, something like that. So the baby who did really form this couple will really close to mom. So when they close to mom, we will call another one, like we want they feel close to us we call by using the word mom side so no one call at a stranger po ya or ah if you can notice so also in Thai law mom is very important to if dad and mom didn't register or sign the contract marriage contract baby usually belong to mom 100% even the man sign contract sign to guarantee that the baby belong to him but did not sign the marriage contract the baby belong to mom so even mom poorer than that but in Thai law baby must be with mom so mom important in any way in our culture so first this is what I gonna detail for you to understand what is the most important for us to call people we need the relative identifying so it's very good better and safe not to it polite and safe and everything so is it good to use it and first of all we need to know your age to identify that